Hello, this is Paul, and this is Doodlelog Stardate 50919. In this exciting episode, I arm myself with a charged green Lamy Al-Star loaded with an untapped cartridge of violet ink. I call it purple ink, but the box calls it violet. I prefer purple, so for the rest of this video, I'll be using purple ink. Although, this does get me wondering if I might actually like purple ink better if it happened to be called purple ink. And since I've never doodled with purple ink that's called purple ink, I'm going to need to say that I'm just not sure. I will need to buy some purple ink soon, because I'm pretty sure that I'll like purple ink that's called purple ink just as much as I like this ink, which is purple, but is called violet. And well, for the sake of this discussion, over which something as important as to whether or not this is purple, I do need to say that when I look at this ink in a different light, it may actually be violet, or maybe it's just a lighter shade of purple. Whatever color this ink is in the end, all I really want to say is that I had lots of fun doodling with this purple ink. As a matter of fact, it was so much fun that I can't wait to doodle more doodles with it, and that I want to doodle some doodles with purple ink that's called purple ink. So, as I doodled my way through this purple doodle, I ran into some difficulties, both of which were with the paper. And this happens to be a Crescent Render sketchbook, and as much as I like this paper, it's not great for fountain pens, and I forgot about this until my first blop. The problem is that fountain pen ink feathers very easy on this paper, so you need to be careful, which I'm not good at, and you need to be cautious, which I'm also not good at. So, if I happened to draw a line over a line that was already drawn, or if I pressed too hard, or if I tried to darken a spot with more ink, a big spill of ink would start to feather out like gooey lava oozing across my paper, sort of. If you watch close, most if not all of the places where there's darker shaded areas, these are spots where the ink feathered. And the ink didn't just feather a little, it feathered in large purple blobs that were difficult to work in, so I just ended up drawing a dark line or a dark fill to cover up the blob. And since I was just doodling a doodle, this worked out fine. A bit messy, but it was okay. The other difficulty was that the more ink I used, the more the corners of the paper wanted to curl up. Now, it's one thing when your dog wants to curl up next to you on the couch, but it's a completely different thing when your doodle book wants to curl up while you're doodling. I didn't like that as much. This must have something to do with fountain pen ink, or the amount of ink the fountain pen puts down, or the way the ink dries as it dries? I'm not sure. But this did make doodling a bit more difficult, and sometimes I drew lines I didn't want to because the paper sort of chased after my pen if I wasn't careful, and as I've already mentioned, I'm not very good at being careful, especially when I'm doodling. I mean, I'm sort of trying to be careful, but being careful or taking care are not the most important thoughts in my mind as I wander through the vagaries, nuances, details, and the other flotsam of my artfully ambiguous doodle. Fun is what I'm thinking about. Fun lines and fun shapes, or maybe what album I should listen to next, or should I have chocolate cake for dessert or not? Well, you should always have chocolate cake for dessert. And on that note, that's all I got for today. Thanks for stopping by, thanks for watching and listening. Remember to keep your pen on the paper, and see you later. Until next time, goodbye.